Hi, we're the Putman family, and we've been attending Highview East Campus for about 9 years now. And our journey into foster care and adoption started in the fall of 2014.
We were in a brand new season of life. We had just moved into our first house and had one little girl named Piper, and she was about 6 months old.
In November of that year, Highview did a 4-week sermon series all about caring for orphans. And we knew that there was going to be a clear call to do something at the end of that series. We felt like God was just stirring in our hearts, and we had had several conversations and just prayed about having open hands and obeying whatever he called us to do. The extra bedroom in the house that we had just moved into started to feel like an opportunity.
On the week that they preached about foster care, I was working at the hospital, so Ben went to an interest meeting about becoming foster parents after service. He called me right away after he left the meeting and told me that we really needed to pray and consider foster care. Honestly, I was scared. It sounded hard, intimidating, and we just really didn't know much about foster care at the time.
I'm sitting in this interest meeting, and they were sharing different myths and objections that people have that keep them from committing to being foster parents. And one of them, I'll never forget hearing it for the first time. They said that people often worry that they will get too attached, but these kids in foster care are experiencing all kinds of loss, and they're bearing the weight of broken relationships that they should never have to bear. The very thing that they need is people who are willing to get too attached to take some risk so that those kids don't have to feel it.
So we signed up to be foster parents through the state cabinet. And in September of 2015, they called us and said they had a little girl that needed a home. Kimber was 2.5 weeks old when we first met her in the hospital. Our community group just surrounded us in those early days as we adjusted to suddenly having two little girls under two. They watched Piper for us, they bought a double stroller, they brought meals, they prayed, and they just walked with us.
Immediately, our hearts were knit to this little girl, and we just loved her. But it took a day or two, I think, before we actually said out loud what we had both been thinking, which was, if we get the chance, we want to keep this little girl forever. The possibility of her going back with her birth mom, we knew the risk. And it was both heartbreaking and joyful. Heartbreaking because it would mean loss for us and our family, but also joyful because kids belong with the people who made them.
It was almost 2.5 years before we were able to adopt her. It was long and hard and a lot of waiting. But we did adopt her on December 18th, 2017, 1 week before Christmas.
We had had Rosie in the summer of 2017, so we're a family of five these days. But we're in the process of opening our home to be foster parents again. We feel like the Lord has not released that call on our lives. The prospect of taking another placement into our home and then sending a little boy or girl back is probably more daunting now. It's still scary and heartbreaking to think about.
But we have hope as we've been preparing our girls for another child to come into our home. We just keep coming back to one central truth. We can do hard things because Jesus has done the hardest thing of all. Jesus stepped into our brokenness and pain, and now he calls us to do the same thing for others. And we can live sacrificially and take risk because our hope in him is secure beyond all doubt. And we, just as we have been redeemed by the Lord, we are watching him redeem Kimber's story.